My name is Phil. I live in North Central Wisconsin and I prospect for gold. Today, we're out just checking out a couple creeks, get some material, take it back and run it through our cleanup shop, see what kind of gold there's in here. We can locate gold in this creek. We know it's a good spot to come back next spring and do some sluicing here, set up our sluices. So we got real good gravel on the bottom here. I'll show you a little bit of what we got. See that nice gravel there? We got a whole bunch of it in this creek. We're classifying it out, bring a few buckets back home and test out our shop and see what we got. So I'm going to dig a bunch of this and I'll be right back. Okay, we filled up 4 buckets, 3.5 gallon buckets, and looks really good. Some real nice gravel in there. This looks like a real nice creek. It goes a long ways and it's got some real sharp bends all the way through here. Good gravel deposit, not too hard digging either. So we'll run this at home and test it and see what's in it. There's some gold in there. We know where you got a spot to do a lot of sluicing next summer. This is all big hill country. Real big ridges around these lower areas. And this area has been known for finding gold in it over the years, so looks promising. Okay, we're back at the shop. Got those buckets with us. We filled up from that creek. Got our sluice set up. I'm going to start running through the Gold Hog mini sluice. And hopefully we find some gold in here. Keep running this. Do some adjustments on the water flow. Looking good. And I'll get back to you. Okay, we got both operations going here. Al's got the big sluice with a big Gold Hog mat in there, 10 inches wide, 36 inches long, and he's got the carpet on the bottom with the expanded metal and ribs. And I got the mini sluice here with a Gold Hog mat in it. It's looking good. There's gold in there, we're gonna catch it. One bucket run, starting on my second one. two buckets run through here. Al's got his two buckets run through the bigger mat, and he's putting his on the miller table now. See if he gets any gold out of there. First scoop, no gold.
No gold, first scoop. The good stuff is coming.
Okay. Usually at the bottom of the bucket where you find it.
In other words, you
got one piece there so far. Just got two pieces, or one piece out of Al's two buckets. So we'll run mine, see what happens there. Okay, put one scoop of my stuff on there. Got one piece already. Got another piece. There's another one. All together we got 7 pieces out of 12 gallons of material. Now that just all depends on where I dug in that creek. I can move over a little bit and get a whole bunch. I can move over a little bit more and get nothing. So it's a test. We found out there is gold in there, and they weren't little bitty pieces. They were halfway decent size. Could have been bigger than to get up on the beach. So get enough of those, they add up faster. Anyways, we'll go back and get some more. We might, and depends on how much snow we get, we'll set up our sluice in there. That creek might not freeze over all winter. So we'll have some fun in there anyways. Well, we had a lot of fun just playing around out there on the creek and coming back here and playing around with the sluices, seeing what we could find. And no matter what we do here, we have fun. Just something that we both really enjoy, and I'm really thankful I got to meet Al and get to do this stuff with him. So I hope you liked the video. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, leave me some comments, and come back to the next one, because we're going to go back out there and get some more material and find some more gold. So I hope everybody enjoyed it, and may the gold in your sluice be plentiful.